pay, then you're okay. Money, it's a gas. Grab that cash with both hands, then make a stash. New car, caviar, four-star daydream. Think of money, a football team. I'm all that jack, it's on my stack.
Oh, boom.
The money, it's a hit. Don't give me that too good, a good
point. All right, guys, welcome back to another Beyond the Catch segment. Now, you just seen those big fish coming on a popper, but there's some very definitive clues and techniques that were involved to get those big fish. Yes, is it a private lake? Yes, it's the lake I live on. Is it super easy? No. I could take any one of you out there and put you on there right now, and you will struggle to probably catch five. Sure, you can go throw a wacky rig Senko around, maybe catch six or seven fish, but they're not going to be the right ones. There's this exact little pattern happening right now, and I'm going to break it down for you guys. Now, you won't be able to tell because my popper is far away. Those were GoPro shots. But you will notice, you'll see me like hesitate a little bit before I set the hook each time. Now, that clue right there is because my popper went and did something really funny. What that real funny was bluegills and red ears tugging on that feather. So the pattern was running areas where I actively found red ear or bluegill beds and fishing tight as I can to the heavy cover near those, because there's bass that always stay in the heavy cover. There's always some tanks. If there's bluegill or red ear beds around, the nearest heavy cover, the nearest boat dock, I guarantee you has a giant living under it. If you casted that or you flipped into that area and you tried and you didn't get bit, you should return every hour to every couple hours if that's an option for you. So the details here, so I'm going around and I'm catching them, and you will see me hesitate, you will see me stop, you see me working the popper very, very slowly and very subtly. The reason why I'm working very, very subtle, I'm not trying to go bloop, I'm not trying to draw a bass up out of staying water, deep water, I'm trying to merely shake it and do a little bloop, little splash to get that panfish's attention to come up there and hit that feather. When the panfish start to conjugate around those beds or rise, those bass in that heavy cover see that. And this is a great time for you to watch this. The bass post spawn is going to be happening really soon here across the country. Bluegills are going to be spawning for the next couple months. And this is a technique that, trust me, you need to have ready to go. So when you're getting that little bloop, bloop, just a little subtle one, it's getting the attention. And what you're gonna notice is, why in the heck does Nick have a blue reel? This is just some Cast King blue reel, and I have 12 pound monofilament line. Normally I throw all of my topwaters on braid unless I am going insanely slow, which is usually maybe a popper. This is a Yellow Magic popper right here. A pop R is gonna be just fine for you guys. You don't need to go spend 30 bucks on a popper. Go get one from Walmart. Now the monofilament is clear instead of the braid. And the basis for this is my popper is sitting almost dead still for long periods of the time, and when the bass come and eat it. Now, the fascinating part about these bites is you're going to see that it is pretty darn windy. I'm working it very subtle, and I'm strictly focusing on my popper to see if it disappears. Hardly ever am I seeing a big boom when the bass eats it. Every now and then I get lucky, that happens great. I appreciate it when they do that for me, but they're just going under and they're sucking it down. And you have to be cautious, so what I'll do is when they suck it down, you see me analyze it, get a tight line to feel if it's heavy, then I'll swing on it. Because those red ears and bluegills are pulling it down, the bass comes up in between, sees that easy opportunity, and eats it. So one thing I have right here, I have a loop knot, and I'll give you a nice close-up on that loop knot in a second here. It's a very subtle way of moving your bait. A loop knot allows your popper to kind of move a little bit more naturally, allows it to kind of just shift in the wind without the line tension working against it. It's very subtle. And I also did the braided line trick to my hooks, because oftentimes when those bass just barely slurp it down, they get one hook point in that braided line trick to your hooks. Do you have to do this? Absolutely not. Does it help you land more fish when they get a single hook on them and they can rotate 5 or 6 times before the hook binds? Absolutely is going to help you land more fish. This is the Styx hybrid stick. This is the number 3 in the styxfishing.com lineup. This is a medium power, moderate fast. Allows me to throw a popper a very long way. So what I want you guys to think about here is fly rods. That was amazing. I just knocked over 15 rods. But what I want you to think about here is I'm getting tight to the heavy cover or structure. For my lake right here, it's mostly just cover. It's sago pond weed. It's a type of tall weeds. But any grass, any boat dock's going to work. And I'm going as slow as I can next to that heavy cover to see if I can get that popper to shake or twitch because of them grabbing that feather. That is very key. If you don't see that, visually go around, look real fast. Do you see bluegills? Do you see bedding bluegills? Do you see bedding red ears? Have a little panfish set up with you. If you can get bit on those things in an area, that's also a great area to trigger those bigger bass. So by knowing there's panfish there, these are the key zones that I'm circling around to. I'm not trying to cover lots of water to find these fish. So the true keys is super subtle, slow, clear line, being able to make a long cast to stay off these fish, the panfish to get that done, making sure I feel weight, because once you grab and the panfish has your feather, they'll just let go of your popper. But this will work anywhere in the nation if it's happening. You see bluegills or red ears or some sort of panfish bedding, I guarantee you Big Mama is right there. I'm Nick the Informative Fisherman, guys. Follow me on all the popular social media channels. Thanks for watching.